Hello everybody, welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm your host, Damon Pettit. And it's kind of a seat of the pants doing a review. I kind of wanted to do one today, and then so I got my coffee and everything, I left, and I forgot to get a cigar. So then I went to my favorite place, Ambassador Cigar, and out here in Arizona. And I went ahead and grabbed this Alec Bradley cigar. And I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce that. Coil, maybe? You can actually see my breath right now. And hopefully get to see some flame with this thing here. Come on. Take a look at this cigar here. Looks pretty nice, huh? Probably can't see it real well. Lighting is not exactly studio lighting. I know that you're used to my perfect lighting, but this is going to have to be what it is today. And of course, I'm kidding. This bitch is a little peppery right now. I'll have to get all the actual information. I ran and grabbed this, and cannot believe I can see my breath right now. Pretty crazy. So I don't know all the particulars. I'll have it, and we will put it right here, right between my hands here. So all the information should be right here between my hands by the magic of the internet. Wow, can't even believe how. My Pete's coffee, and luckily it's still warm. But this is I believe it's a newer one of the Alec Bradley cigars. I remember, I think it said, let's see, some sort of classic. And it's a mixture of a bunch of different tobaccos. I know that as well. I can't remember the exact one, you know, all the exact info on it. So, like I said, I'll do that. At the moment, though, it got a little bit of a kick to it, a little bit of a spice, a bit of a pepper. I breathe steam and smoke all at the same time. It's got a very nice draw. It's been a long time since I've done an Alec Bradley cigar. I was really into them for a little while. And then I moved on to other things for a while here, so. Feels like it's going to go really well with the coffee. As you can see, it's cooling down now. It's beautiful out, but a little shocked that it's cool enough for the breath thing, but it's all right. It probably means it's a little humid or something. I don't know. But today there's supposed to be a meteor shower thing going on, so I saw one. It's not one falling star so far, but it's supposed to be like a lot of them going on, so I'll have to kind of look a little later. Hope everybody's doing well. It's Saturday, the 12th or something like that. I'm not sure what day it is. It's a nice day for a cigar.
Haven't been having a whole lot of time lately to smoke a cigar, and that's very disappointing. I've had a lot of questions about, I got to get about 1,000 emails every other day, and I'm kidding, I get an email every now and then, and I've got no questions, so there's no questions being asked. Let me put this in there, touch stage. Well, you can hear me. I'm trying to think if there's anything big. Just regular. I don't like to go over anything anymore. I think that might be another reason why so many crappy things going on in the news. Let me see here. Oh, my favorite cigar store, it actually moved, and it's pretty cool. That's huge and really nice, and it looks like they're still getting it completely stocked up and stuff, but it's gigantic. I'm probably going to take some pictures of it here. I'm pretty sure it'll let me, and send, or at least have it in one of my reviews and stuff like that. Coffee not bad. It's been sitting in my car now for a couple hours. I think it's, what time is it? About 11:30 or so right now. So about 3 hours, and it's still warm. So I'm a little bit shocked. Thermos isn't as good as some of the. It's actually not a bad thermos, obviously, but some of the other thermoses out there will keep your like piping hot for hours and hours. This is a few hours, which is all I really need, so that's good. Let's see. Let me talk about how this cigar tastes, since that's kind of what this is about a little bit. That extreme pepper kind of went away, which is, I'm not a huge fan of a really peppery cigar, so that's kind of cool there. There's a there's a cat that's just like eyeballing me, just like that. I gave it the cat eyes back and just still looking at me the same way. Hello. I don't think it's gonna come to me though. Looks a little scared. I don't know. It's coming. Come here. I don't have any food for you though. Very cute. A little bit on the burnt toast taste right now. It's not charred toast, but just say it's a little bit scorched, and you want to, you know, you still eat it. It tastes okay. You throw some butter on there, and but it's got that little bit of black brushed. It's like somebody took a little paintbrush and just a little bit over it. That's kind of what I'm getting. Kind of a sharp cheddar. That's the feel that's in my mouth anyway, like when you eat a sharp cheddar cheese or whatever. I was in a cigar store, obviously, and at some point I was, wasn't I? And there was a gentleman in there talking to another gentleman. And he was saying how he hadn't
been smoking cigars because he was afraid to.
He was afraid to do it wrong.
And so I want to make sure everybody knows. Can you understand me? Huh?
Make sure everybody knows. Cigar is your own experience. Now, there are good ways to smoke your cigar, you know, to cut it, light it, all that shit. But there's not the only way to do it, you know? Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of the cigar. You are the boss of the cigar that you have. And you decide you want to give it a guillotine cut, give it a cut. If you're afraid to cut too much off, you can get one of, like this one here is pretty cool, because you can't cut any more than that little much off there. See, so it stops right there, and then you cut it, and unless you keep cutting, you're not going to cut too much off of it. So if you like the guillotine cut, and you want to not fuck your cigar up, right there. Then there's the little the punch cut. A lot of people like that. You can. A lot of people have those on their little keychain or on their. It's already on their lighter. Then they have that. There's what else is that? That other little B cut thing. I've never personally had that. I think it's a cool cut, but I've never really used one of those. I don't even know if that's the right word for it. but don't be afraid. Just experience it. Don't go into something with rules, you know? You don't want to do stupid things like take it, chomp it off and bite it in half, you know. Obviously, you give that a try and see how it works for you, but more than likely, it's not going to be the best way for you. Now, like I was saying, there's, you know, there are definitely ways where I think, you know, lighting your cigar or something can be better than others, maybe, as far as what you use. You don't want to really use a Speedo lighter. Really don't want to use one of those, really. A Zippo lighter. You want to try to make the flame as clean as possible so that you have you don't get kerosene in your cigar. Butane is probably the best, and wood matches. A lot of people will, I think, for the feeling of it or whatever, will light a piece of cedar wood. You know, they usually have that in a lot of things, and they'll light their cigar with that. You could do all kinds of things, but don't be afraid. Just experience it for yourself and do what works for you. And if you want to try other people's, you know, they like to bite the end off. Bite the end off one of your cigars. Maybe start with a cheap one in case you screw it up. No big deal. But the cigar is, like, at least for me, is very it's your thing. You know, it's your time to hang out, your time to do what you want to do, to think about the shit you want to think about. Think about the girl, the guy, whatever it is. If you're a lady and you're thinking about your guy, you're thinking about your woman, whatever it is, you know, it's your time, and you need to enjoy it and do it however you want to do it. So I was a little bit, you know, the guy that was there was telling him the different ways, and wasn't really telling him that there was just one, you know, one kind of way to do it or whatever, but I just know that there are more people like that gentleman that was in there that feel the same way. They're, you know, they're a little bit overwhelmed or whatever by the cigar. Don't be, you know, it's like anything else. No matter, and I know, I'm sure all of you have done the exact same thing. There's been something that kind of thought about doing, maybe you thought about it. So you thought, and then finally something happened and you were doing it, and all of a sudden you're like, oh shit, what am I doing? I can't believe I'm doing this. And it all worked out great. It worked out perfect. And you're like, what the hell was I so scared about, you know? So it's, you know, it's kind of like that. You don't worry about it. You just do it, see how it works out. Worst case scenario, if you pay $5 for the cigar, you blow $5. If you pay $30 for the cigar, you blow $30. Who cares? Now, a lot of us would rather not blow $30, but, you know, if that's the worst case scenario, then I guess there, it's not that bad. I'd taken a bit of a deep breath there for a second.
Oh. How's everybody doing?
A little bit tired today. Actually, pretty tired. Driving around tonight and kind of didn't want to be driving around anymore. This cigar, not too bad. I haven't really had any problems with any of the Alec Bradley cigars that I've had. I've always, I don't know, I've enjoyed the ones I've had. I've enjoyed their marketing, I guess you want to call it, with their bands, the look that they have with the different, you know, it's not all the same. And that's pretty cool. This one's I don't want to say pretty. It's a very nice looking brown. Wish somehow that's closer to the color that I can see, or that I'm looking at. The light kind of really, it's almost, this is close to a reddish brown color. Looks a lot like a Brazilian type wrapper. I'm sure it's not. I think it's, I don't remember what it is.
Don't remember.
But, because I was able to, I found it on my phone, looked at it really quickly, but that's it. Huh. I just noticed something that I'm going to have to look at later on. I don't know what the hell it is on my phone.
Ooh.
Beautiful out here. It's not snowing, and I'd be shocked if it was. The whole time I've lived out here since 2000, we've had two little spits of snow. One time it actually was on the ground for about 30 minutes or something like that. It was pretty crazy. Another time it just kind of came out of the sky a little bit. Perfect opportunity this entire week for me to have been riding my bike. I did not do it one time. I'm very ashamed of myself, to be honest with you. Really kind of pissed off at myself. Because the entire time, like in the morning, I'd wake up and I'd have to, when I do it in the morning like that and go to work, have to leave about 4:30. And it was like 59 degrees. It's perfect. Still wear shorts, you know, have a couple, I have this jacket that is great. And then I usually have a t-shirt and a sweatshirt on to kind of keep my core nice and warm. And I was lazy the entire week. And now it's going to be chilly. So, and by chilly, I mean like in the 40s. Or like right now it's 40 something, I think. Not exactly sure what it has to be, the cedar breath, but I'm gonna knock the ash off of this little bitch. Hello. It's burning good still. It has a great draw to it. If I remember right, and I hope that I do, because I'm going to say it, the process that the Alec Bradley cigars go through, I'm pretty sure that they have, and I don't know if every cigar maker has that, this thing, this technology, or whatever the hell you want to call it, but I'm going to put my other headphone in there. Hello. They have a machine that can test the draw of the cigar, and which I think is pretty cool. You know, you don't want a cigar where you can't draw anything from it at all. You don't want a cigar that it feels like you're sucking through a straw. You know, so when you get a cigar and you smoke it and you get some smoke and but a little bit of resistance and all that, it makes for a nice experience when you smoke your cigar. I enjoy that. And it's got a really nice aroma. Really nice. The flavor, still, it's kind of being consistent.
Sorry.
I'm yawning like it's something I have to do to save my life or something. I don't know.
Oh, that's nice, huh?
Hi. Sorry. Tell you what, I'm still really loving the coffee press. Very simple way to make coffee. The way I made it when I was a kid, and yes, I had coffee when I was a kid, but my, and I'm talking like when I was probably 12, 10, my parents, they had a percolator, and it's a, for those of you who've never seen one, it's like a metal pot, and it's got this little, got like a this plastic bubble thing on the top of it. It looks like a little, it's like a little handle that you can pull the lid off with. Probably don't know, but anyway, then yeah, it's got a stem, a little thing that sits in there. You put the coffee in, put the little lid on that, then you put the lid on it, and you put it on the stove, and you sit there and let the water boil. Then when it starts to boil, you'll see it in that little lid, see the little bubbling, you know, and then. I can't remember what it was, but like, you know, my parents used to taught me how to do it or whatever. But you would, I can't remember, there'd be a couple minutes or whatever that you'd let it, when you'd start to see it percolate, you know, you'd let it do it for a little bit and then you'd shut the stove off and set it aside and have your coffee. And I mean, this is back a long time ago, and that was kind of my first coffee pot that I had too. And then when I was looking for this coffee press, I you know, it's kind of like all these, they have all kinds of different coffee presses, and it's pretty much I don't know if one is better than the other, you know, if a certain glass or anything else is better. I happened to get a couple of them because of the cost at Costco. And I have one at work and one at home. But anyway, I was looking around another store, and they still sell
those percolators.
They still sell them, and they're $16.
I was a little bit surprised by that.
I almost wanted to buy one just for the nostalgia of it. But, you know. No. Let me see. Football's still going. Now, one thing, we'll talk about football here for a couple minutes, just because it's the only sport I watch, really. I mean, I dabble, see other shit, but football is a sport I like. The Arizona Cardinals. Everybody keeps, and I would be one of them too, I think, but pretty much has written them off from day one, from beginning of the season. And, you know, the division seemed like it was going to be somewhat tough with Seattle and San Francisco and the Rams. And then, of course, quarterback for the Rams got hurt. So that kind of put the kibosh on their season a little bit, just because they didn't have a Kurt Warner like they did back in 2001. And but they, you know, the Cardinals keep getting hurt. I mean, it's crazy. I don't think I've seen a team decimated as much as this team, Arizona, has been with injuries and still continued to win. In this last game, they even, you know, their backup quarterback got hurt, and the other guy came in, and the game was close to, it was in the fourth quarter, so, and it was just nothing but field goals in for the entire game. But they still pulled it out. They still won. And I love that. I love it when everybody writes a team off. And it's a foregone conclusion that so-and-so team isn't going to win. That, you know, this team is going to do that. All that kind of bullshit. I really hate that. It's probably one of my biggest pet peeves. And I hate that kind of, in a general sense, with everything, when the press or whatever it is says that this is exactly the way it is. And it's like, it's never the way it is. And especially when you're talking about sports. It's the most ridiculous thing. Now, the odds are so-and-so will happen and all that kind of crap. Yeah, that's the way that is too. But to just act like, you know, they just step back from the future and said, well, this is what's going to happen. Fuck off. I hate that. I really do. And for those of you who get a little bit turned off by the F-bomb, I apologize. But every now and then, those come out of my mouth. So, and I don't bleep.
A little bit chilly out here today. A little bit chill.
Didn't wear a hoodie, so my ears are freezing. That's the one thing. When you got this going on, you got nothing keeping the heat in at all. It just straight on out. So, for those of you with a full head of hair, go fuck yourself. And, that's one thing you can be happy about, is that you're probably a little bit warmer than some of us. But still not bad. Still, I remember when I used to work at this golf course in Colorado, and it was, I loved it. It was the one time I loved the winter time, because when it would snow, there's no golf. When there's no golf, I had the course to myself. And it was great. Didn't pay worth a shit, but I wasn't really doing it. I was doing it, obviously, it was my job, but
It was nice. It was great. It was a great place to work. Anyway, what was it? Oh, the weather. I would start without having a hat on, and about 30 minutes into it, when I was almost wanting to freeze to death, I'd throw a hat on, and boom, like that, I could tell a complete difference with my the temperature and being warm and everything. It makes a huge difference. Anytime I happen to stay at my buddy's house, a lot of you who watch or have watched a lot will have seen him with me, Vince. When I stayed at his house, he likes it to be about 30 degrees in his place. And so I'm pretty much, like when I, usually when I go out there for a vacation or whatever, I'll stay at his house for a night. And, you know, if I had like one of those big down sleeping bags, I would probably have that, but I don't. And so I have like clothes on, and I put hat on. I sleep. it's fucking freezing. But anyway, this is looking pretty nice. It's burning good. 30 minutes into it. See if I get any different flavor here. A little bit sharper taste. A little bit like a, it reminds me of, it's not the flavor, not the taste of it really, but it reminds me of a really black coffee. And that's kind of what flavor I'm kind of getting with it. And of course, as I've said many times, your taste is going to be different than mine. If you, you know, are a vegetarian and eat nothing but vegetables and fake cheese and all that other shit, then, you know, you're going to have different flavors come to you. Your cigar is going to taste like the, well, no, vegetarians I think might eat cheese. It's a vegan. So if you're a vegan and you're just eating vegetables and the fake cheese and the fake meats, then this might taste like the that Daya cheese or whatever they call it. And I don't understand why vegans call stuff meat. Like, they'll name something chicken. And it's not chicken, obviously. It's a vegan meal. But they have to, they really need to start naming their own food differently. And if you're a vegan, I'm not come down on you. I'm just saying, name it something other than chicken. If you all don't like chicken, don't want to eat chicken, completely understand. No meats, all that stuff. There's a thousand different reasons why I understand why people go that way. I'm not one of them, but anyway, why don't you name it like for the fake cheese that you have, the cheese substitute. Name it orange melty, you know, something melted topping. Topping for your vegan pizza. Something. I mean, I don't know. I just, it really irritates me. I'm like, oh, what is this? What kind of, oh, it's not meat at all. I don't even know what it is, you know, it's usually, what is it, usually soy or something? I don't know what making stuff out of, but it's kind of crazy. I don't know if I would ever go vegetarian or vegan, to be honest with you, but there's a lot of things I believe as far as the different nutritional value of everything. not that our food has the same nutritional value as it used to back in the day, a long time ago, or even when I was a kid, but. Burn line is very nice and thin. Very nice. When I get home, I'm going to have some wine and some little pretzels. Very hungry for those right now. And I'm going to get warm too. Because when you sit outside and it's a little chilly, after a while you start to get a little chilled. Now let me see. Anything else going on? Not really. Like I said, football season, it's getting towards the end. All the playoff scenario bullshit's going on. Whatever. Some people will end up in the playoffs, some won't. Somebody will end up in the Super Bowl, somebody will win the Super Bowl. I'll probably watch it, depending on what happens. Blah, blah, blah. Hopefully, I'm trying to think if there's anything else I really wanted to talk about. Can't really think of anything. Not really. Any of you ever experienced anything with MSM? It's it would be a supplement that you would take, and it's for, helps with joints, cartilage, different stuff like that. And I'm just wondering if any of you have used it for anything. If so, let me know. I'm using it right now. Not right at this second. Well, actually, it's in, yeah, probably. I probably am using it right at this second. Just don't know it. But anyway. Anything else? There used to be something called the do not call list for your cell phone or whatever. I think that's all gone into the shitter now. I continuously get calls that are like commercial calls, you know. It's like, what the hell? It didn't used to be that way. And I've ended up on a list or something. I don't know what's going on, but really irritating. That's about it there. Hope everybody's doing well. Hope everybody's staying even keel with the holidays coming up. Makes people go crazy. It puts a good feeling in the air for a lot of people and a bad feeling for a lot of people. So just wish I was able to help out like everybody, you know. this time of year, you always want everybody to feel good or whatever. It's the one thing that I do love is the smell. Like, it reminds me of when I was a little tiny kid about the smell of a Christmas tree. I love that smell. But yeah, that's going to be about it tonight. I'm going to relax for a few minutes and finish this look up and see if I could see any more shooting stars for the night. And that's about it. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you for watching anytime that you ever do. I know it's, my shit's long and I just sit here and ramble. But I know I've done it before with other people, and I know that some of you do it. You just, you know, sit there, smoke and watch and that kind of thing. That's very cool. That was my idea in the first place of the reason why I kind of want to start it doing this. And just to kind of hang out with you, even though I'm by myself, like an idiot. I'm just, you know, rambling on all by myself. But thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for commenting when you do. You never have to, but if you ever want to, I love it. And feel free to tweet me. And...
Facebook, I'm putting my shit on there, but I really, you know, I don't keep up with my Cigar Review TV Facebook thing very often. I know I need to be a little bit more consistent on that. I'm trying to get my videos cut up onto there. But I don't go on there as often, at least posting shit. So anyway, thank you. It's been fun smoking with you once again, and I hope you have a fantastic day, whatever day it is for you. And just hang in there and love your life as much as you can. We're only here for so long. This baby here was about, I think it was like $8, if I remember right. Oh, I actually had the fucking receipt right here. Hold on. I might ruin everything. No. Shit. I can't see it. Yeah. $8.40. So... No, it was $8.20, and it was 22-cent tax, something like that. So it was about $8.50. Rounded up. So $8.50. I'd say it's well worth the $8.50. It smokes very nice, very good taste. Just consistent flavor, consistent draw, consistent burn. Very nice. Still see my breath. Okay, everybody. Have a good day. Good night. Whatever day it is, whatever night it is. Enjoy it. I'll be smoking with you again very soon, and I hope that you're having a good day. Take care of yourself. Thank you very much again. I mean, honestly, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for watching, and I just look forward to another one. See ya.